Now, I would like to call upon one of the most engaging and joyous professors in our institute. From getting into the best attire during winter carnations to conducting survival cooking classes. He has been a true motivation among the students. Please give a huge round of applause for none other than our Dean of Student Affairs, Professor Harish PM.
Thanks, Shivang. And Tanu, am I getting your right? Getting your name right? Okay, thanks. All right. Somebody mentioned that this batch has the fewest number of SAC cases. I guess Professor Madhu and I will have to have a meeting on Monday. I think there have been some cases of plagiarism. Some people have plagiarized my speech. So you will see. So you'll see some repetitions. Anyway, graduating students, let's hear some noise once more. Awesome. How many of you feel like staying a few years longer? No? Okay, ready to go out? Great. So yesterday, when I was thinking about what else I could say here today, among so many speeches, that would be of value, I realized I have nothing further to say to you guys. I have shared with you whatever I have to say over the past years. There's nothing more, you know, I'm going to say to you. There's nothing more I can teach you. Instead, I thought of reflecting on things that you have taught me. Three incidents come to mind. One of these incidents relate to all UGs, masters, and PhD students. The second one relates to only UGs, and the third one relates to only mechanical engineering students. However, I feel the insights I've gained from these incidents are applicable to all of you, so worth mentioning here. You are the pioneers of this campus. You came here when the hostels were barely ready. I think Professor Pratik Mutta said Wi-Fi was spotty. In fact, I think there was no Wi-Fi. Am I? Okay. So no library, no labs, no shops for miles from here. No street lights, no footpath. Sandeep, you mentioned something. Where is Sandeep? Sandeep is somewhere there. Sandeep, you mentioned something about the footpath that you guys did in foundation program. I should say that was a shoddy job, but that's a separate story. And then, oh, about the trees, Mr. Birman, I think they had said at that time that they will only get the no dues if they had taken care of the trees. So let's make sure that we check before we sign the no dues. Anyway, but you know, the foundation program almost didn't happen for you guys. Because I remember just 2 days before the foundation program, the Audi was very much a construction site. I still have photos of Professor Bharadwaj Kolappa and Professor Abhay Gautam, and perhaps a couple of other team members in hard hats touring the construction site just 2 days before you guys came in. Nevertheless, the foundation program did happen, but you guys were in stuffy auditoriums without air conditioning, pedestal fans, no fans, okay. And I think also a whole bunch of millipedes walking on the grounds, if I remember, crawling on the ground, if I remember correctly. And not to mention washrooms where sometimes there would be no water in the flush. You guys remember those days? Okay. But you got through that. Within a few weeks of you moving in, I remember the open house we had in PC about campus issues. And I remember that quite vividly. I remember thinking how maturely you were handling it all and how you had all suddenly grown up. Second incident, second year dynamics and vibrations class. This was the transition year in which we were moving dynamics and vibrations from the third year to the second year. So this year, you were second years then, were taking the course along with your seniors who were in the third year. And I remember right after the midsem, some of you second years came to me and said, should the grading be different for second years because we are competing with the third years? You guys remember that, some of you? Yeah. Okay. So I think I said nothing doing. Second year or third year, you guys are all the same. But then when I went back, I thought I should check how the second years are doing with respect to the third year. So I remember checking the second year mid-sem average and the third year's mid-sem average separately. And do you guys remember what I found? The second year average was higher than the third year average. So you rose up to the challenge, right? Now, fast forward to these past few months. I have been observing many of you from close quarters, especially the student leadership. And I don't mean just the student council, but also coordinators, club secretaries, senators, captains, many of you, student guides, including many masters and PhD students, just like Shreya, who just spoke before me. In them, as Professor Pratik Mutha also mentioned, I think in them I saw many accidental leaders, I think. It was an unusual year, nota, multiple elections, many people taking on double roles. And it so happened that 5 out of the 8 council members were mechanical guys who I had taught 2 courses. Of course, this year, your junior year, they have changed this trend of mechanical dominance, which is a good thing. Because I think mechanical guys are outstanding, but too much of a good thing cannot be good, right? Anyway, so I had seen many of you guys in class. Rahul was studious, introverted. Is that a good way to describe you, Rahul? Okay. Sandeep, I don't even know how you won your elections with that manifesto of yours. Rushali was, you know, soft, gentle, soft-spoken. So, and I can speak about all of the others. At that time, I didn't imagine how, you know, when the election results were declared, I couldn't imagine you guys in leadership roles. But what a job you guys have done. Outstanding. I should congratulate you on that. And again, I don't mean just the student council, but the entire student leadership. I think all of you have really done an outstanding job at leadership. I saw each one of you grow into such challenging roles in such a short amount of time. And by leadership, I don't mean organizing events or new initiatives, but really much more than that. I mean, you guys were so good at team building, delegating, nurturing others, maturely handling conflicts, and so on and so forth. So what did I learn from these 3 incidents? It's a simple realization, really. You already have it within you. You just have to put yourselves in a challenging or adverse situation and you grow to be able to face it and excel at it. You don't need somebody like me to teach you. You already have the learning capacity, the introspection, the critical analysis, and the habit of consulting widely to be able to learn and grow from such situations. So I leave you with the simple message that you have taught me. Boldly go do what you are afraid of. Everything else will fall in place.